So hello my beautiful YouTube family. This is kind of spur of the moment. My husband was out feeding the horses in the forest pasture, and you noticed something wrong with Fiona.
Yeah, she lays down all the time, and then she raises her up, and then she lays her down again.
Yes, so something is obviously wrong. So we are going to go and check on her immediately. Hey Fiona, what is wrong? Why are you laying down, standing up? Hey. Now she's moving, standing with the fence. Let's see what her plan is. So my husband is getting a thermometer, and we are going to check if she have a temperature or not before I call the vet. Always before I call the vet, I do some stuff because I know that the vet will ask me, do she have a temperature? How is she doing and stuff like that? So I always check before I call. Because if I don't, I just need to check it and call right back. So see what her plan is. She is digging a bit. I don't know if she's kind of bored or if it's like it could be like a callback. I don't know why she would have a callback, but we are starting to grow up some green things because the spring has come, and maybe she has eating something, but I don't think we have, and of course I know we don't have anything poisoned in the pasture. Verde? Are you talking? Yes, I'm trying to film Fiona. Hey. Let's see what she is going to do. Oh, she is laying down. There is something wrong. Yes. I think... Who are you, Fiona? Yes, there is something very wrong. I think I'm gonna call the vet straight away. Fiona, daddy is coming really soon, and when we're going to check your temp. Yes. Do you have pain in your stomach? I believe you do. Så jag pratade med... Yes, I'm talking English in this episode, I forgot. So I talked to the veterinarian, and he wanted me to do 3 things. Check her pulse, check her breathing, and check her temperature. He was on his way to another colleague horse. He will call me back soon, but I will do this with Fiona now and let you know also, of course. First, I need to put a halter on. Fiona is laying down again. I think I will see if Shania can stand there. Hey, who are you? You can see on her eyes, but she's kind of looks like sleepy, so she's not doing well at all. I will try to put the halter on. Yes. Can we lay down and put the halter on? That would be awesome, actually. Easy. Oh. First I was thinking if I should remove the other horses, but I think Fiona feels safer when we are with her. I'm going to hold her and you are going to check her temp, Jesper.
Yep.
I will rub on her. And you show her the thermometer so she knows what's happening. Yes. That one is going to your butt, Fiona. Shall I bring her forward a step or?
Yes.
Come. Whoop. Wait, we are not ready. No, we are, I think. So, I'm gonna stop filming now because I want to touch her a bit and rub her. Yes, 38.1 degrees. It's really difficult to check her breathing and to check her pulse. We will try a little bit more before the vet calls. So I let her go for a while, waiting for the vet to call back. Of course, I will stay here and see so she doesn't start rolling or something stupid. Oh, are you, sweetheart? Yes, it's bad. Yes, I think Fiona is laying down again, so I will take her mother out and hopefully she comes too. She's going for a walk. Yes, no, she's up and walking. That's great. I'm coming, Nicky. Come, Fiona. Hey, Mama. I go there. Close to your baby. Come. Mommy. Maybe we can be here on the stones for a while. I don't know if you see, but Fiona is almost as big as Nicky. That's crazy. How are you doing? She's not tail in the mouth.
Gum.
In the gum. And that's good. That's also one thing I check with Quadic. Or every time a horse is sick, actually. Hey. Oh, you are dirty, Fiona. I think this actually is really strange because no one of the other horses is sick. And Fiona and Nicky had a colic kind of this summer, but that's a really long time ago. I don't know if some idiot walked by and gave her something or what it's all about. Yes, Fiona, you are getting some brushing. Was that nice? Yes, I think that was perfect. And Nicky, you are such a good mother, just standing here. Although you have a rope around your neck. But anyway, I can see that Nicky do understand. We have a lot of mosquitoes in the forest. We actually decided that we will take Fiona and Nicky to the stable. Because it's easier, it will soon be dark, and it's easier when the vet is coming. Yes, so now we are on our way to the stable. Are you okay?
Yes.
And Nicky is doing really good. I wonder what the other horses will say when we get friends coming up. Yes. Now we are in the stable. Hey, Lavendel, Frosty, and Madonna. Yes, so now we are in the box. That is actually Lavendel's mash water And that would be perfect if Fiona would drink. Because that's the thing I give them when we have a colic. I will make some new water and remove Nikki a little bit. Yes, it's that trusty Nikki. Hello. Another girlfriend. Wonder what Lavender will say about that. And Fiona and Frosty, I think you never met actually. No? Hey, hey. What do you think about this, Lavender? Pretty strange. You had a boyfriend for a day. And Madonna, what are you saying? Not much. Are you talking, Madonna? Saying hello to your new friends. Friends you haven't been seeing in a long time. Yes. How nice of you. Was it Madonna, Nikki? Yes, it was. Hey, Fiona, drink that water. That will do you really good. What are you doing? Hey, what are you doing? And you are talking. Yes, you are. And we're making some new water for Fiona. Yes, let's see if Fiona will do the lavender snorkeling thing or not. I hope the vet will call really soon actually. But no, she is actually standing up and that's good. But colic can always turn around really fast in the wrong direction. So I want the vet to check on her to be sure it is colic. Look at this, a really big moose. And where is Jesper? I don't know if he sees it, but Lambie sure does. Lambie! Oh my god, there was another one. What is happening? I don't know. Oh! Lambie, it's okay. Yes, so this day feels like it's getting crazier and crazier. I had to go inside for a while. Because I had no battery in the phone. And the vet actually called me. First time I called him was like 6:15. When he was on his way to another horse. But he will come after that horse because that horse was apparently more sick than Fiona. I'm just checking for moose. I don't know what I will do if we are come running. And the problem is, oh, that was you, that I don't see them. They probably see me first. And that's a really big problem, I think. Yes, so when I was inside, Fiona actually pooped really much. Fiona is sitting, laying down, looking at her stomach. Yes, we are on our way to the indoor arena with Nick and Fiona because we are going to walk Fiona for a while. We are going to let her go for a little while and see if maybe she wants to walk by herself. Yes. Always when Fiona comes in here, she starts to run. So if she don't, she's really sick. It was Nikki that started all that. I just wanted Fiona to walk around taking it cool, but I think I might have to put the halter on again. Fiona is doing this Arabian thing. You can say again. Yes. We only run for a little while, so I think if we just walk around now, it will be perfect. You wanna do her Arabian thing? Yes. Easy. Snorkel. Are you looking at yourself? Yes, you are. Is it a beautiful horse, Fiona? It's you. Yes, it's you. It's you in the mirror.
Yes, I can say that it wasn't really easy to film with the mobile phone because we have another camera when we do the vlogs. But it wasn't time. And I wanted you to be with us while we were doing this, in the moment actually, so.
She is digging, lifting her tail. But she has been walking a lot and that's good. Yes. You walk on, Fiona. I just felt Nikki's udder. It's really, really, really filled up. So I don't know if Fiona hasn't been nursing all day or what, or if it's something that makes Fiona sick. I don't know, inflammation or something. But when I felt it, it felt even and just big.
Yes.
When the animals get sick, I get so worried always before I know for sure what it is and if the vet will come in time and stuff like that. Yes, Fiona is so. Fiona is actually drinking, and that's really good. And Nikki wants to drink all, but she's not allowed now. Very good. Oh, Fiona. She is not doing like Lavendel.
I'm sitting here resting, trying to rest with Lavendel for a while. Lavendel. I'm so tired. Yes.
Fiona is actually nursing, and if it's a good thing, because Nikki's udder was really, really full. And I'm worried Fiona hasn't been nursing all day.
The vet is on his way. Hey, I think actually Fiona is looking a little bit more like she is a little bit, you are seeing what she's doing. But I will let the vet I will let the vet check her out just to be sure, because you never know with colic, so I wouldn't feel confident and safe going to bed without the vet checking on her actually.
Thank you. Har du koll på dörren där? Det känns som den är öppen.
Ett år gammal, jag hade aldrig haft kolikkänning förut.
Ja, oh, i somras.
I somras? Jag
hade okay. Både mamma och Fiona kolik samtidigt. Mm. Tror att det var för att de hade gett hästarna något skit och jätte. För de gick på samma grönbete som två andra hästar, men det var bara de här två som blev sjuka. Mm.
Hej, Fiona.
Det är okej. Han ska bara känna och titta på ditt tandkött, gumman. Det är okej. Mm. Han är snäll.
Mamma.
Ja. Oh,
fina hästar.
Tack. Det är bra, Fiona. Du är duktig. Och du är duktig, mamma. Mm. Yes, so her temperature have raised a little bit to 38.6. And now the veterinarian is listening to her. And I think Nikki is so good standing there. And Fiona is a star too. At the moment, anyway. Yes, so he listened to her now, and the right side is kind of quiet, and the left side is stomach soft.
Pretty normal.
Yes, pretty normal. That's good. This is actually one of the reasons why I train the foals from the day they are born, because you never ever know when you need to have a vet or anything out. And I really like them to be able to be handled so no one gets hurt. That's important. So, wait a minute.
No, she is going to get some painkiller, we can call it, to release the pain. Bra, Fiona, vad duktig du är. Vad duktig du är, gumman. Stilla. She is doing that really good, I think. And the veterinarian too. And Jesper as well.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Oh, Fiona, you are a star. And Nicky too.
Ja, bara så du vet. Runt klockan 10 är jag här.
Ja. Toppen, tack så hemskt mycket.
Hej då.
Hej.
Yes, now we were done. And the vet are leaving. It was actually the same vet that was here with Madonna, and I think he's really good.
Yes, so the veterinarian just left. I got some directions to follow tonight for Fiona. He gave her some more pain relief that actually will help her for like 12 hours. And we are going to go outside tonight, of course, and give her a little bit of hay and walk with her here in the stable, because that's a good thing. Yes, so I'll be back, and this is feels actually like good news, I think, because Fiona feels so much more awake and alert.